There is a solution for the hum and the buzz you might hear in your home theater or media receiver. Toslink. Unlike all other connectors we have presented, Toslink is made from plastic or glass. The name comes from Toshiba Link, and it was initially created in 1983 to connect a CD player with a receiver.
It uses an inexpensive LED light source for transmitting digital audio, and because it's using light, it's immune to electromagnetic interference or radio frequency interference, even if you decide to put the power cable near the audio signal. It also helps in cases when the cable has to be very long. A high-quality Toslink can even reach 30 meters, although usually you will find up to 10 meters.
So why Toslink is not popular? I would say it had bad timing, just like Kodak digital camera. But there is more to that.
The fiber is limited to about 90 kHz, and it's not as good as coax if you want a high-quality sound. Moreover, Toslink uses SPDIF format, and this can add, in some cases, jitter to the audio signal. Optic fibers are not only used for transmitting audio, but also for television signals, internet communication, and other data types with the speed of light. We are going to talk about two types of fibers, multimode and single mode, and their most common connectors. You've probably seen them in data centers connecting switches, routers, and servers, but you can also find them at the bottom of the ocean.
Optical fibers are much better than copper wires or coaxial cables. First, as we know from Toslink, they are immune to electromagnetic interference.
Secondly, the bandwidth is much bigger, tens, hundreds, or even thousands of times bigger than copper wires. And thirdly, fibers have much lower signal attenuation, which means it can reach tens of kilometers.
Basically, there are two types of fibers. Single mode and multimode.
Multimode is mostly used in local area networks, security systems, and general fiber networks. It uses 50 or 62.5 micrometer core and has higher attenuation and lower bandwidth compared to single mode. On the other hand, single mode uses 9 micrometer core and is supplied in backbone networks and telecom. It is a single mode because it allows only one mode of light to propagate at a time, whereas multimode, due to its bigger core, allows multiple rays of light modes at the same time. Usually they are orange or yellow colored, however multimode can also be aqua, violet or green, depending on its standard.
So, let's have a look how the connector and the cable are constructed.
The fiber has three main parts: coating, cladding and core. The core is the light transmitting region of the fiber. It's made of silica. The cladding is also made of silica, but from a different composition, different refractive index, which ensures total internal reflection. At the physical contact, we have a ferrule that is aligned within a sleeve with another ferrule.
The FC connector has a threaded body and it was designed to work in high vibration environments. The name comes from ferrule connector, fiber channel, or as its inventor called it, field assembly connector.
The ST, straight tip, has a twist on coupling type, and it was one of the first connectors to be used.
The SC stands for subscriber connector, or as others call it, square connector.
The connector uses a push-pull mechanism, which is much easier to handle than the FC. It uses 2.5 mm ferrule to hold the fiber, just like the FC, and was developed by NTT. On the other hand, when there is a need for some space, the LC is preferred because it uses 1.25 mm ferrule. The LC uses snap-on mechanism and was created by Lucent Technologies. In some cases, you might find additional letters by the type of the connector, like PC, APC or UPC. The letters refer to the polished type of the ferrule in order to minimize the light reflection at the connection between the two fibers. Ultra-polished contact allows for efficient fiber-to-fiber connection, while an angled physical contact provides very low signal reflection. Mismatching polished types of the fibers or any other angular misalignments will cause great signal attenuation and lower bandwidth.
We've said enough about connectors and cables. We've covered them almost completely. But this is 21st century, so cables can be troublemakers. Maybe this is time to go wireless.
Like it or not, make sure you subscribe. The next are coming. If you need more information, read the description below and have fun